Hi, I've done some more testing on the mechanism of static tip bows using quarter scale PLA bows. These results are from the use of longer ears. There are three different lengths of ears in this test. That is L, which stands for large, which are 400 millimeters long. We also have the best bow from the last test, which is only named 35. Then we have medium, which stands for 300 millimeters long, and then again the best bow from the last test. The entire name of them is MM, miniature Manchu, M, medium, 35, which is 35 degree angle, and that's the ears, how much to point forward. In the past video, I mentioned that the leverage should take effect at half your draw length, and there is one exception to this. If your ears are long enough and the bow doesn't stack, the leverage will hit 100%, meaning there is no incline anymore. And if you look at L35, it's horizontal. It is actually even negative in the beginning, and then it starts to stack, and you end up at the same height as when the leverage started to take place. If you compare L22 and L35, these two bows store the same amount of energy. So L22 is the example where you get more energy with an earlier leverage effect, and that's because the ears are so long. If you look at the table to the right, we can see they are almost on the same height. L22 is a little bit higher. If we look at percentage here, which are referring back to L35, we see that L22 is a 0.5% more energy. But this is an example where the ears are so long that they will cause instability. The bow will twist because the ears add leverage towards you, but if the bow is a little bit crooked, it will also add leverage sideways, and the bow will break if you get leverage sideways. So historical Manchu bows are maybe between 20, 23, 30, 24, maybe up to 25 centimeters between string bridge and the nock. So 400 millimeters is very long. There is no historical record. This is a exaggeration to amplify what happens if they're this long. Medium, you can see M35 still has the M35 has slightly more energy than M25, and M medium is 300 millimeters long, so it's still longer than any historical record. So for storing more energy, you will want the ears to be as long as possible, but that will cause instability. So I would recommend starting with 200 millimeter, and then for each bow you manufacture, you make it a little bit longer until you reach a point where you don't have any stability anymore. Because the worst thing that can happen is that the bow break. If you look historically, if you know a warrior has a bow and the bow break, he has no combat value anymore because he doesn't have any weapons. So the conclusion is the same as the last video. The bowstring should be in contact with the string bridge until half to your draw length. And the angle of the ears is dependent on your draw length and the brace height you have on the bow and how close to the handle the bow limbs bend. You want them to bend as close as possible to the handle because that will delay the leverage effect. So I have contacted some bow manufacturer in hope of getting a Manchu bow with a higher Siyah angle. I'm hoping to get something about 35 degrees, if it's possible. I haven't I only got negative replies, so we will see about that. Therefore, I started a process of manufacturing my own bows, which will take time, and I will go directly for horn bows because there are better bows when it comes to these kind of bow. Because the downside of laminating bows, a modern lamination, is that the cross section becomes a rectangle. And rectangles have bad torque resistance, and torque is in the twisting, the sideways force from the ears. So the more circular an object is, the better torque resistance it will have. An oval shape, which we see on the Manchurian bows, it's very good shape, other horn bows, like the Turkish or Ottoman bows, they have more of a half circle. So the back of the bow is flat and the belly is a half circle, which is also a great shape because you get more torque resistant. And then they add ridges on the back, the flat surface, to get a stiffer bow further out on the limbs. And when you laminate, you use two flat surfaces that you press together and laminate wood, which means you get a flat belly and a flat back. And those aren't torque resistant, and therefore, when you have these long ears, the leverage will add sideways, twisting and torque. So if you look at modern replicas, laminated bows of Turkish or Ottoman bows, they have the correct angles of the ears because the ears doesn't have enough leverage to cause instability. But when you start to look at the Manchurian bows, when the ears are so long, I don't think the modern bows have enough stability in the bow limbs, so the angles get lower and lower. So the bows I have are about 11 degrees, which is way too low. So I think we should re-evaluate how we manufacture with lamination. We need to get a more efficient way to distribute the mass of the bow limbs so we can get torque resistant or twisting resistance in built into the bow limbs. So the conclusion of this test is same as last video. This is just to amplify the results.